Welcome to this edition of The Front Row as we get you up close and personal with Wingate student athletes and coaches during the 2010-2011 athletic season. Today on the show, we'll preview the Men's Basketball South Atlantic Conference Tournament as Wingate plays Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Joining us today, Brian Good, but first we'll talk to junior guard Jaime Vaughn. Jaime, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me on the show, please.
The Wingate men's basketball team, picked to finish third in the preseason, went 12-6 in South Atlantic Conference play, 17-9 overall. The Bulldogs finished second, but lost a tiebreaker and will be the number three seed coming up in the South Atlantic Conference tournament. The Bulldogs will host Brevard Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Jaime, congratulations on a great year for you guys. Right there at the top of the league, just a couple games back of being in that first spot. You know, a lot of the same guys coming back from last year to this year. A lot more wins, obviously. What's been the biggest difference in your mind?
I feel that it's just more experience. We had, a lot of our guys were freshmen last year, and including me, I was a sophomore. And I feel like now that we've had a year under our belt, got to play with each other, got to know each other a lot better. Now we've started gelling more, and it's more about the experience that I feel that's helped us this year.
He won 7 out of 8 to finish the season. A big part of that was obviously Odell. What did his success have to do for the guards? Open up a lot because, we saw a lot of double teams and he had a lot of great chances to be a point guard a little bit down there in the post.
Well, he's so good because he passes so well out of the post, and it helps us guards because we know that if we pass it in there, we know he can score, but not only that, you're going to get the chance of getting the ball back. And with a lot of other posts, you might pass it down there, and a lot of guards might just go back, or going for the rebound. Well, we know with Odell, we can spot up, and we know he'll pass and find an open person.
You finished for the best record in the second half, 7-2. Won 7 out of 8, but lost the first game of that second half to LMU. You're 5-5 coming home from LMU and finished 12-6. Down the stretch, won some great road games, and most of the games were 5 or 6 points, and just I'm sure it meant a lot to you guys to say, hey, even though we're young, we won a lot of close games. What was that big difference down the way?
I feel like Coach always stressed to us that we were this great team, and we knew where we could be, but we kept playing under the radar, I feel. And finally, we just got to a point where we just got tired of just winning two games and losing two, then winning two, and we was just like, we know we need to step up to the level that we can play at, and that's what helped us in that 7-1.
On a personal level, you've played a ton of minutes already in your 3 years. From the start, all conference last year, and now a junior leading the team in minutes. On a personal level, having to take a leadership role with Mike and Chase. How much has this year been different for you on a personal note?
Man, like you said, it's a lot of pressure on me. Like you said, playing a lot of minutes, being the leader. But I take full responsibility for it. I know we have a young team, and they need someone to look up to, who's they can come to, and they when they feel that things aren't going right or whatever, and I give them good advice and stuff like that. So I feel like I played a big role.
Brevard is the opponent. You play them for the second time in 5 days, and you swept them during the regular season. But interesting enough, last year this time you were at their place for the conference tournament. They went on to win the tournament after they beat you. Now they come to your place. What do you remember most about the two games and, coming up for Wednesday night, the strategy again?
It was our defensive efforts in both games that helped us throughout, and I feel that we come in with the same strategy. They have, a good guard in Roper, and, sometimes he's going to get it, sometimes. But I feel like our defense is good enough to where we can stop him and give us success and win the game, as it did two times before.
In conference play, you go 6-3 at home and 6-3 on the road. Pretty impressive for a young team to win that many on the road. But at home, 6-3, and you won, all of them that last month except for that last game of Anderson. Yeah. Playing at home, so important for you guys. How much will it stress on that to protect your home floor? And because you've gotten yourself to this point by playing well, and now you have a chance to get to Hickory with a home game.
Well, at home, man, it's a big, very big advantage because you have the crowd with you, and you always want to protect home. So I feel like this home game is very big for us. It's going to help us out a lot. The fans, like they say, coming out and playing at home and not going on the road is good because the past 2 years I've been on the road.
Jaime, thanks for being here, and congratulations on a great season. Good luck Wednesday.
Okay.
Welcome back to the front row. Jaime Vaughn just joined us, and joining us now, Wingate men's basketball coach, Brian Good. Coach, thanks for being here.
That's my pleasure, Ryan.
Coach, gratifying season for some accounts. 12-6 in the league, finished second, and just a couple games left out there during the year. But can't hang your head and have to be proud of the way the season went.
Yeah, I mean, we obviously set some high goals for the season, but I'm certainly not disappointed in this group, given we're still a young basketball team. We got better. We improved tremendously from last season to this year, not only in number of wins, but in our maturity level and our defense in the half court. So some things came about this season that, for our program's sake, needed to happen. So I'm very pleased.
It seems like it's been like the women's team in some ways, just a total team effort. You've had so many little contributions off the bench, but they've meant so much. You know, Jeff's 7 blocks in 8 minutes at Newberry. Guys like Eddie and Rob to come in and play some big minutes, and then you still have your starters out there doing what they're supposed to do. It's got to feel better that way, as opposed to having, one guy jacking up 25 shots a game and getting wins and just hoping that he's on that night.
Yeah, I mean, that's been my philosophy as a coach for a long time. I believe that we're a team, and if you have just one or two guys that can score, if my team is facing a good coach, they're going to find a way to try to limit that and make somebody else beat you. Whereas I hope to establish a team that we're just going to take advantage of the matchups, and the guys that get the opportunities are going to score. And some nights that's been some different guys, but we've had obviously an Odell and Jamie, two pretty consistent guys. But had they been on another team, Odell might be taking 20 shots a game instead of 13 or 14. So, but I like our balance. I like the fact that it's you leave Chase Smith wide open and he's going to score, and Rob Carpenter comes off the bench and you don't find him, he's going to score. And so we've gotten contributions from all those guys, and I think that's what's made us a pretty good basketball team.
Even that first year, we struggled so bad on the road, 2 years ago. And to turn around this year and go 6-3 at home in the league and 6-3 on the road, what do you say to that? What do you make of having such a balanced from both places?
Well, I think it's a testament that in our league, you saw what a bunched up group it was after us and Anderson at all at 8-10. And I think it was just a testament that we had a very balanced league. I think we had a best team, and then and us and Anderson, two really good teams. And then a bunch of teams on a given night were tough to beat at their place. And on a home night, you still needed to show up and play basketball. So, I think our league is probably taking a little bit of a hit because of our non-conference wins. But I think teams like Carson Newman, Tusculum, Newberry, without a doubt, with a new coach, they're not the same team they were back in November and December. And unfortunately, when it comes to postseason, we go back and we look at games you played in November and December. And for our league this year, it probably hurts us a little bit. But, I don't think there's anybody I'd want to play some of those teams right now.
With Odell being so successful, I asked Jamie about it. We talk a lot about maybe at the next level, they talk so much about going inside out and, having to close in on a couple guys. Odell's seen so many double teams and triple teams. He's figuring out how to dish the ball and find open shots. Was that part of the original thing to say, hey, we got to get Odell started to get everybody else looks? Because, the team has run pretty well with Odell, starting the offense.
Yeah, it's been an interesting year because we – Odell kind of went through a little slump, but to start the year, I thought just wasn't the same player that he was to finish the year or even for the majority of the year last year. And I'm not so sure that didn't make our team better because we had to find other ways. We lived without Odell putting up some big numbers for a while, and then seemed like at some point it just started to click for him again. And once again, I think he's become the best low post scorer in our league. And obviously, when that happens, the shots that Jamie gets and Chase gets and even Padraic and Odell and Quan, all those guys, they're just easier shots. Their guy is not only guarding them, but they're guarding Odell too. And when he establishes himself and starts playing with the confidence that we know that he's the best player down there, it makes all the rest of the guys more confident too.
It's not so much that you're playing Brevard for the second time in 5 days, but for the second year in a row, the roles were reversed. A lot going into this game, maybe too much for your liking. Just having to play them again, already beat them twice. They ended your season last year in the same spot, and they went on to win the tournament. I mean, it's an eerily strange situation from last year.
It is, but, you know, I think it comes down to, and what we talked about yesterday and what we'll talk about again today, it's a one-game season right now, and we don't need to worry about anything else. You know, we don't need to worry about Saturday's game or the previous game, you know, or last year's game. It's a one-game season, and, you know, win tomorrow and keep playing and lose, and your season very well is probably over. So, you know, we did what we needed to do to play at home on that Wednesday, which we set out was a really important goal for us, and now we've gotten that. So, you know, it's just going to come down to doing the X's and O's, following the game plan, listening to the scout again, and doing what we need to do to win a basketball game.
The game at their place kind of got into a little bit of an offensive shootout. Both teams, you know, your team obviously shooting the ball so well, but when you played them at home, you know, 46 points for them in 40 minutes, an excellent defensive performance. You know, what game will we see for you guys to win, do you hope, on Wednesday?
Yeah, for me, I probably hope the game that we played at our place. Yeah. You know, that's a little bit more to my liking. I thought we defended really well that game, and you know, we did a fairly decent job at their place on Saturday. I think the 23 offensive rebounds were a concern, and but we've been a good team when we've gotten stops. You know, I've challenged these guys in the last couple weeks to become what they set out to be, and that's one of the best teams in the league defensively. And giving up 80 points, 77 points is probably not getting that done. So we'll try to be a little bit more of that first game style in the game on Wednesday.
Especially in this league, you know, we'll talk about Hickory, not so much worrying about whether you guys will be there or not, but so much in this league, you know, playing on someone else's floor with their fans, with the situation, the travel is always so tough. But, you know, if you were to win Wednesday night, you'd play at 8 o'clock on Saturday night, and you know, the neutral floor, as a coach, does it matter much? Is it a big deal to play on a neutral floor in a great setting like that?
Well, I'll be honest with you, Ryan, I haven't thought much about it right now. I'm thinking about Brevard, and you know, I've done nothing to prepare for the weekend. I want to live in the moment, and I want my guys to live in the moment, and when I talk to them, I want them to know that I'm right in the moment with them. So we'll worry about Friday, Saturday, Sunday, after we take care of business on Wednesday, and then you know, and then we'll focus on Saturday. I'm just you know, this group has been a group that they're very good when we're focused in the moment. You know, I heard Coach Nelson talking about that with her group, and we need to stay in the moment, worry about the game in front of us, and then let those other things take care of themselves. You know, back when we got ranked in the region, I thought that was maybe as big a part of those two losses that week as anything. I thought we started thinking about postseason and all that stuff, and maybe didn't play our best basketball. And you know, we need to worry about Wednesday, worry about Brevard College, how are we going to stop Josh Roper, how are we going to rebound the basketball, and then we'll think about Hickory and when, once we take care of business.
Coach, finally, you know, with the NCAA coming up, you're not in, but you're right there on the cusp, yeah. Which if you're not going to be in the, you know, top four or five, then maybe you want to be, if you can't be in, you maybe want to be right there on the edge, because it gives the guys extra fuel to say, hey, you know, more than ever, it's win or go home. So, you know, you can't look ahead, because if you lose tonight, you know, you're not going to the next game, you're not going to NCAA. So if you got to be right there on the edge, I feel like your team's in a good spot to stay focused on, you know, wanting to be in that top eight.
Yeah, and I think when it comes to the conference tournament or the NCAA tournament, especially the NCAA tournament, as a coach, I know our team right now has no idea what that's like. And I'm sure if you'd ask the Brian Greers and the Sean Barnetts, you know, once you go, you want to go back, you know, because it's a pretty neat experience as a basketball player, and you realize what all that work went into, and all those, you know, months of training and practices. Now you get a chance to go be part of something, and you can feel it that this is, you know, now we're in something. We're one of the elite teams in the country, and I certainly, when we set out this year, wanted that for this group, because I think once you experience that, then you never want to miss out on it. And we still have a young basketball team, and I think if they can get a taste of it, you know, they can hear my words, but maybe put a story with it that makes sense to them back in October, that this is what we're playing for, this is what we're trying to accomplish. So, you know, those are important goals, and it's great to have a tangible, you know, tangible goal that you know that what it's all about. And these guys, you know, I think we're a basketball team that can beat anybody in our region. You know, I want to do what we can to get in it, because who knows what will happen after that.
Well, Coach, it all starts Wednesday night, 8 p.m. against Brevard. And congratulations again. Thanks for being here.
Yeah, thanks, Ryan.
All right, Wingate head coach Brian Good.